Welcome to the 7th episode of Inside American Independent Cinema. Today we are going to talk about 1998 feature debut film directed by Whit Stillman, The Last Days of Disco. The Last Days of Disco story centers upon a group of young social friends from New York City that are bound together by the amazing rhythm of disco music. The two main female characters are Alice, played by Chloe Sevigny, and Charlotte, played by Kate Beckinsale, two women who work for a publishing house and which are going to experience every bit of their life and trying in this case to find the perfect match and try to find their happiness. They will soon find out that life is unpredictable and only by making the right choices you can achieve what you really want. The director of the movie, Whit Stillman, connects a time and a place that truly inspired him, or a space from which he has reminiscences, or a space that on the contrary terrified him or made him put some existential questions. And this is the case also from The Last Days of Disco, in which time, space and place are all associated to New York, actually to the 1980s disco night clubbing in New York. And we will see that practically the space in which the lives of the characters start to intertwine and which the main dialogue takes place is this nightclub, which becomes not only a dance scene, but also a place where alcohol mingles with interesting discussions and interesting connections. And this is the perfect setting from which Whitman starts to characterize his characters and starts to develop an action that will eventually have a very bitter ending.
How'd you get involved with environmental causes? I think that's great.
You're interested in the environment?
Very much so.
Actually, there's one theory that the environmental movement of our day was sparked by the re-release of Bambi in the late 1950s. And for many members of the baby boom generation, it was traumatic, the hunters killing Bambi's mother.
Yeah, that was terrible.
For six-year-olds, it's devastating. To this day, no one wants to identify with those hunters.
I think you're right.
You're living in some women's residence, aren't you?
Yeah, it's terrible. No guests.
Huh.
really nice.
Thanks. Would you like anything to drink? What?
Could I have a Pernod?
Sure. This is supposed to be good for cigarette mouth. Do you smoke?
When I drink or go out at night, I usually smoke. I live dangerously on the edge. I'm no kindergarten teacher. What's this?
I collect original edition Scrooge McDuck comics. No, it sounds a little odd.
Not at all.
This is original artwork by Carl Barks, who created the Uncle Scrooge comics. He's considered a bit of a genius.
There's something really sexy about Scrooge McDuck.
You really think so?
I love Uncle Scrooge. But if you want to know how I really feel, get the cameras rolling, get the action going. Baby, enough, our love for you is real. Take me where you want to, man, my heart you steal.
We will have to be very attentive of the main theme of the movie, which is letting go of the past. Practically, what all characters do is they are letting go of the past in order to properly go through the future. So the nightclub is not only a space where people mingle together, drinking alcohol, dancing, or having interesting conversation. The nightclub is also like a scene that emphasizes upon the idea of the evolution of life, and we will see that in the 1980s the disco era was going to fade. It was the end of an amazing era full of happiness and fulfillment. But for Stillman, this was only the beginning of something much more bigger. And as we all know, the 1980s was a decade of changes that arose very fast and that practically were in all sectors of life. So Alice and Charlotte are not only best friends and are not going to have simple conversations or intellectual ones, they are somehow characterizing and representing a type of character that can be each and one of us, because in the end they will have to say goodbye to some comfortable life in order to fulfill their dreams and aspirations. So Stillman emphasizes upon love, loss, and despair, because yes, despair can be a part of our lives. We will see very much collision, many actions in the nightclub that will forever change principle, the main masculine characters, namely death. And even if in one point they will try to escape, to run away from their nightclub tensions, they will eventually let go only metaphorically of this dance scene, because this will be the beginning of their real lives. They will start another and different and very full of perspectives lives. And Stillman does have this great satirical and postmodern commentary upon the difficulties and obstacles that can occur in all our amazing lives.
Dancing bars in the old days. People ever really dance in bars?
People my older brother's age, they did.
Your brother must be a lot older.
If
before disco, this country was dancing wasteland. You're the Woodstock generation in the 1960s that was so full of themselves and hated? None of those people could dance.
I'm crazy about you. Now go now with your bad self.
Thank you so much for being here with me in this anniversary episode of Inside American Independent Cinema, because Behind the Scenario has just had his great celebration of 3 years of existence. Thank you very much for watching us, and I hope you will have an amazing September, because we are heading towards September and towards autumn, and like I said to you in a precedent episode, this month and this autumn will be full of amazing movies. So let's meet together very soon to comment upon not only American independent cinema, but upon cinema in general. Till then, kiss you and see you soon. Bye.